The amazing coincidence with the previous author. Thank you for what you read about your experience in this field, because I'm going to do almost the same. I'm going to read two poems, but not about my experience, but about the experience of people I've talked to, or better to say, talked to me. They agreed to tell me about what they had gone through. These poems are from my documentary poetry site for Kaimani, which is based on this real speech of real people who are suffering from different mental disorders. And its main idea is to give these people an opportunity to talk about themselves, to tell their story, because I don't know how it is in other countries, but in Russia, they suffer from loneliness and isolation, sometimes even more than from the diseases. Irina. Among us, not only I hear the voices, but also my mother, sister, deceased father. They hear me, what my voices sing. And they have their voices. I know this for sure. I only hear my voices. They're hounding me because I was the first to emit the voices. The others around me see with my eyes, and my feelings are transmitted. It happens in people's brains, but they can divert their attention and not see anything mine. The others around me see my dreams, better dreams. Extraterrestrials have their way with me in different manners. These dreams are held together by the others around me. They want to observe this. The voices revile me in the latest manner, revile my mother. The others listen. Sometimes they speak out in a strange way. Everyone has turned away from me. The others around me are silent. Irina also shared with me parts of her private diary, where she wrote down everything that was happening to her. September the 22nd. They declared I'm a child. They deny the woman in me. That's how I understood them. Woman, child. I never considered myself like this. I was independent, lived in a hostel. They said your hands are of the child. Your speech copies that one of a 5-year-old girl. You speak firmly, precisely, as I understood, with separate sentences, not talkative. October 27th. Today they did something for my guttural sound to tremble, put a pain on me. The moaning voice began trembling. The entire city calls me. They give me away to anyone. Now even the various marks were of air. Not one of them, perhaps, have to lie so much under such violent humiliation, without steering either a leg or an arm, so that people would see how you lie there naked and how everything happens to you. For they came to me for a long time, while I couldn't get up from the floor. I got up, started crawling. With my hands, I touched the cold floor.